Alright guys, welcome back to part 2 of the January 2015 Final Banlist Discussion video. Pretty much you guys have been commenting in the comments section below about various things about this upcoming banlist, what you think, questions that you want to ask me, and I will be go ahead and talking about these things. So, ton of comments, ton of things to answer. I had to actually push the tag partners back because I pretty much have to get this done by the 1st of December. So I'm gonna try to get done with all these comments. So I'm gonna try to get done with as many as possible and get done to and wrap this up in at least 4 parts. So Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, and hopefully get this done. And if we have to go farther than that, yeah. But I know on this upcoming Monday, my banlist prediction will go up. So I'm gonna try to get this done as quickly as possible, so I can go ahead and get my banlist prediction up, getting you guys' opinions and 2 cents on everything. So mostly they're just questions. I was kind of hoping to see a lot of people's actual banlist predictions and see what they think, but a lot of them are just questions. So right now these are Stanzi's questions, so we're gonna go down Stanzi's. He asked a lot of questions, so let's go ahead and answer them. So starting off, do you think DMOC will return? DMOC can return, as long as you don't bring back any broken spell cards that are banned. I feel much safer with DMOC coming back if Soul Charge is banned, because I generally don't like the idea of sending DMOC to a graveyard, Soul Charging it back and other monsters, then of course you'll use DMOC, grab Soul Charge back. I generally don't like that idea, but if you ban Soul Charge, I wouldn't mind DMOC coming back. Do I think he'll come back? I doubt it. Konami, it's kind of like that fuddy duddy, if it ain't broke, don't fix it thing, It generally takes them a long time, a long, 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 long time before they kind of like, crack the shell open and allow something to get out. So, I generally don't think that DMOC this time will be the one to be let out of prison. So, yeah. Alright, next. In Burning Abyss, I think that Tour Guide will get hit to 2 and Skarm will go down to 1. I think Skarm's taken it a little too far for the deck's first hit. I do think Tour Guide will go down to 2, but I don't think Skarm will go down to 1. Tour Guide to 2 is a fine hit. It's been on their list before, set precedent, so generally Konami likes to put things back on the list that's been hit, move it back to where it's been before if it's shaken up the thing, Debris Dragon was at 1, then it went to 2, then it went back down to 1, so I wouldn't be surprised with the strength of Tour Guide and the Burning Abyss. I wouldn't be surprised if they go ahead and just go Tour Guide from 3 to 2 to 3 to 2 again. So, maybe they'll get this right eventually, but this is kind of Konami kind of put it on itself. So, yeah. Alright, Skarm will kind of kill the deck. The problem with Burning Abyss is that they just don't have that many Burning Abyss monsters to work with. So by putting one of the Burning Abyss monsters down to 1, which is lower the deck's consistency to such an immense proportion that it would pretty much just kill it. Because, with only one Skarm, there's not much you can do with that. So, Tour Guide to 2, I can see that. But Skarm to 1, not yet. We'll go ahead and see how they do next list. After we hit Tour Guide and maybe some other things too. Alright, next. What do you think about the artifact engine will be hit this time? I hope it will. It's kind of one of the things that that should have been hit. But it's kind of like, why didn't you hit this? And it's still stirred up. I know destruction wasn't one of the best things, but, non-targeting destruction and just being able to just jump out the bushes and stab your opponent and do all these various things with artifacts was definitely one of the things that was a problem in the previous format. This format, not so much, but as Klee puts go in strength, of course the artifact engine grows in strength, and just being able to ignition pop or summon a sanctum and pop and various things like that will just make the artifact engine more powerful. So it would be healthy for Konami TCG to hit something in the artifact engine and take that down, because this engine to be able to just crush one of, the main thing that they're trying to sell them, which is, of course, Klee Play, is kind of bad. It's kind of bad, So, it has a reason to be hit. I hope that it gets hit. I'd be very disappointed if it doesn't get hit again, I'm starting to think that maybe OCG Konami is making better decisions than TCG Konami, because I thought they had something planned with artifacts and they didn't hit the engine. I was like, well, maybe they're going to reprint it. No, same thing as Eddie's. Like, maybe they're going to reprint Eddie's. But they did nothing with the artifact engine. They did nothing with it. All they did was just an old engine from a previous old set that just caused havoc in the format. So, maybe they can go ahead and hit the artifact engine. All right, next. Do you think that Vanny's will get hit to one or banned? I think banned because it shits on everything Konami is trying to push, like pendulums, synchros, support, rituals, etc. I wouldn't mind if Vanny's got banned, but I don't think he'll get banned. I think he'll probably go down to one. Just because it's supposed to be the fixed version of Royal Oppression, you know? It's kind of weird to have a fixed version of the card and then that version of the card still get banned. I'm trying to put it in the strength category and compare, and I kind of feel like Konami's gonna go down the route where it's kind of like, you know, everybody gets one. If you get it, then hey, congratulations. I think that Konami wants to just maybe put it to one and make it turn into a staple, kind of like with David Vanny's, where, you know, at multiples, yes, it's a very powerful broken card, but maybe at one it'll be okay, you know. So I kind of think that Konami's gonna hit the card down to one, and if it still consists of being a problem, then they might ban it. But generally Konami doesn't do that to a card like that. Generally Konami only takes cards and rips them down from like that number down to zero if they cause like irreparable game states or loop and OTK, but you know, Vanny's isn't one of those cards. With a card like Vanny's who's been at three for so long, I would be very shocked to see the Konami just take this card and just put it down to ban. It just doesn't seem like Konami. Alright, next card. Do you think with Bolt out of the blue, I think it's Bolt from the blue, announced that JDE will hit, that JDE will get hit because Bolt of the Blue, you can summon JDE and nuke the field. Just because Bolt from the blue can do something like that, summon JDE, I don't think that Konami's gonna hit Judgment Dragon or anything like that related. They generally don't look at combos like that, combo pieces like that, especially since it's not even something that, you know, we can even do yet. Like, the set's not even out yet. So, you know, Konami's not for preemptive hits like that generally. You know, they generally wait till, the set comes out and, you know, does something first. So, you know, it's this preemptive hit, you know, with, JD being hit because Bolt and Blue, you know, JD hasn't done anything before, it's not even relevant, like, Swan, so it's gonna go and stay at 3 like usual, so that's easy to say. Alright, next question. Do you think that since Konami brought Regeki back after a decade being banned, Happy Patch, that should return? No. That doesn't make any sense. Like, Heavy Storm is banned. Why the hell would you bring back Harpy's Feather Dust? You're like, no. The reason why Regeki came back is because destruction isn't good right now. You know, it's not one of the things that you want to do. Monster destruction. Backer destruction is still just as great as always. You know, and it'd be very frowned upon to go ahead and Harpy's Feather Dust to return with Heavy being banned. Like, no. You know, like I said, I'm not a big fan of Regeki coming back either. I would much rather giving you two Dark Holes before giving you one Regeki, but I guess Konami wanted to go ahead and test the waters with that. So, no. You can't put Regeki and Harpy's Feather Duster in the same boat, because they're not. They're definitely not, so no. Do you think that 6 Samurai Shien will come to 2? No. I don't think that'll come down to 2 either. Konami's done with 6 Samurais. There's really no reason to move Shien or anything 6 Samurai related. It's kind of an old archetype, and there's no reason to do it, you know. The best that the 6 Samurais have been getting is just indirect support from Rhoda going up to 3, but besides that, you know, there's really no reason to move any of the 6 Samurai support, you know. So, you know, you can just go ahead and keep Shien at 1. It's there for a reason, so, just being able to spam on multiple Shiens can easily lock down a duel depending on what deck it's going against. So, Shiens fight at 1, Gateway can stay banned, you know. The deck's not dead. The deck can still do things, and, you know, it's still a fun deck, but, you know, there's no reason to give it any more support than it has currently. Alright, do you think Gore slash Trag will come to 3 once they had ever played anymore? Trag is more powerful than Gore's. They kind of tested the waters with Gore to 2. I can definitely see Gore's coming back up to 3. Just because it scores, you have to have no cards in the set. I think that's kind of an even exchange with the Gores. You know, in exchange for dropping this nice big old 27 beater and then a token being summoned for a monster that, with the monster that you hit, you got hit directly with, you have to have no cards on the field. Watch Argonia, you know, you can have all the cards on the field you want, as long as you take battle damage, she's doing summon. I think, you know, Trag's ability to take a monster, Trag's ability to copy, I think Trag is much more powerful than Gores. So, I think that Trag will stay at 2 and Gores will go to 3. You know, especially since they test order and Gores were 2 and they clearly saw nothing. They're probably putting Gores up to 3. And Gores is already at 3 now, CG. So, yeah. Alright, next. Do you think that Globe Bulb will get rebanned since it has ushered in consistent 3 card Quasars and is now in 5Ds? Is questions I'm with. No, I think that Konami's actually going to do the opposite. They unbanned Globe Bulb, for the 5Ds collection, despite it being able to do these 3 card Quasars, it hasn't been relevant to the meta, and Konami doesn't look at gimmicky shit, they look at the meta. So, unless this 3 card Quasar tops and wins tournaments, I doubt it, I think that Globe Bulb, since it's another one of those, you can only use the effect of Globe Bulb once per duel thing. I think that it's gonna have the spore effect, and it's gonna go straight from 1 to 3 for the next ban list, and we're just gonna have Globe Bulb at 3. But you can, you only use the effect once per duel, so whatever. All right, next. Do you think 1-for-1 may come to 2? No, no. Especially with Globe Bulb, 1-for-1 is still a very powerful card. With Globe Bulb and 1-for-1 at 1, it's fine the way it is. It's kind of contradictory that you say that Globe Bulb getting rebanned, yet 1-for-1 coming to 2. It's kind of like, alright, like, where are you with this? So, no, I think 1-for-1 will stay at 1. 1-for-1 is still a very powerful card. It's not even 1-for-1's in deck, but just being able to summon level 1 from your deck is a very powerful play. So, no. Alright, next. As for a crazy what-if scenario, do you think Chaos Emperor could come to 1 if the D-Roller and Wyvern were banned to stop Chaos Dragon searching, it becomes a sack win card? Chaos Emperor is the king of the ban list. You can't talk about the ban list without talking about Chaos Emperor, and Chaos Emperor has nothing to do with the D-Rollers and nothing to do with Wyvern, because he never existed when those cards did exist, and going to the extreme of banning the Dragon Rulers and Wyvern just to bring back Chaos Emperor is not worth it, Chaos Emperor is unhealthy in itself, because, you can still search him with things like, with Goldshark. You can put him on top of the deck with the Volatile Chain, so, it's not the D-Rollers and Wyverns that make Chaos Emperor broke. What makes Chaos Emperor broke is himself. There's a reason why he's in maximum security, wrapped up in a straitjacket with a muzzle over his mouth in the center of the earth in maximum super chocolatey fudge covered security, because he is the king of the badness. Chaos Emperor is naturally just an unhealthy card. It's easy to go ahead and sack the living hell out of your opponent, and depending on what deck you use, depending on what deck your opponent uses, I can easily just slow down and duel to a screeching halt. It's just generally unhealthy for the game, especially in the wrong hands. Like just Chaos Emperor and freaking and Burning Abyss, you're on crack. You're on crack. That would just be so retarded. Is to be like, all right, banish a Dark and a Dante, special summon Emperor, send everything. Oh look, I had Burning Abyss monsters in my hand. They're all gonna go off now. Like no, so definitely not. Chaos Emperor can't come back. Next. Do you think Grasp Rabbit will come to 2 if the normal monsters were hit to 1 so it couldn't make 1 card without getting nuggets? That's another one of those ain't broke, don't fix it, not necessary things. There's no reason to go ahead and hit the normal dinosaurs just because of Rabbit. Rabbit's fine at where it is, it's fine at 1. It doesn't need to move anywhere other than 1. In the OCG, they're a little bit more liberal than us, but here in the TCG, we're more conservative, and, there's just no point, What's the reason to move Rashkabit? We're not trying to promote, any more normal summoning, more normal summon monsters. We're not trying to promote Xyz summons or anything along those lines, so, there's really no point to move Rashkabit. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. It's not having any new support, so there's no reason to move it. Alright, next. Do you think Mathematician will go down to 1? I can see Mathematician going to 1. I wouldn't be surprised if it goes to 1. I kind of feel like maybe 2 for this list, and then hit it to 1 maybe later. But for right now, mathematician as a definite pick on my list. I would definitely have him on my ban list. He's a very powerful card, being able to foolish any level 4 or lower, and like I said, it's a nice hit for both Burning Abyss and Fresh Adult. So I can definitely see that as a possibility. So, yeah. Alright, next. Do you think Armageddon Knight will get hit? No, I don't think Armageddon Knight will get hit. You know, if you're going to hit anybody, hit Mathematician. Armageddon Knight's nothing in comparison to Mathematician. You know, Mathematician can send you Bell, I would be running Mathematician, so, yeah. Alright, next. Do you think Curry Bandit will get hit to one? Burning Abyss, Scum can search it. So, if you activate a Scum or Curry Bandit, you will get another one to the hand. FK, 5-1 next turn, speed up, JD, BLS, Chaos, Sorcerer, etc. I was kind of for hitting Curry Bandit last list, just because it seemed like it was more of a fast card, but we kind of stepped away from it. People realized it wasn't as powerful a card as it used to be, and, no. I think Curry Bandit is going to skid by on this list. Maybe when it becomes relevant again, it might get hit in the future, but for right now, it's not, relevant enough to be relevant to even get hit. So, no, I don't think Curry Bandit is going to get hit. Next, do you think Crane will be hit for Burning Abyss? No. Crane's not even being played. I'm very surprised it's not being played. I think Crane is a great card in Burning Abyss, but it's not even being played. It's not even relevant. That's not what we should hit for Burning Abyss. I'm still trying to figure out what we should hit in Burning Abyss, but that's not one of the cards I'm going to put my finger at. Alright, next. Do you think the Shadal card will get hit to weaken the Shadals and Chaos Shadals? Since Meld gets you Shadal Fusion back on the grave, or if you use it when it's using the construct reason, and you get construct blah 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 blah. No. I don't think Core is gonna get hit. Core is not even relevant. I'm not even sure if they run Core. Maybe they run one, but no. Even if they only run one, what's the point of hitting it? No. Yeah. The fusion monsters can get back the fusion, so that's not even, you know, the scary thing, you know. If they wanna go ahead and do that, then it's more power to them, but I don't think Core should be the one that gets hit. Core's not the relevant one. You know, clearly from what we can see from set precedents from the OCG and from, decks from now, you know, how the deck is now, it's not Core, that's the problem, so no, I don't think so. Alright, finally, talking things getting hit, do you think Slate will get hit? I definitely think that Slate will get hit. I think so he'll get punched right in the face, and yeah, that'll be it. You know, he'll be put on the ban list, he'll get hit. No, what the fuck? No. Hello? I get the joke, but no. No, Slate is fine. No, he's getting on my nerves with this whole time sale thing, but no, Slate is fine. Alright, so there we go. There are all of Stonzies. So I'm going to try to squeeze in one more person. I'm trying to, you know, get this done as quickly as possible. But seriously, this is still a lot to go with. So let's go ahead and do we'll do Scraps X real quick. Cause this is kind of short, and like I said, I'm gonna try to still keep these around to like a 20-minute video. So starting off, Vanny Exemptiveness to one. I can see that. That's definitely gonna be on my list. Vanny Exemptiveness to one. It should have been the one last list, but you know, with the reprint, I hope it was worth it, Konami. It was the money card in the 5D's collection, so I guess yeah. Next, Reasoning to one, indirect hit to Infernoids. Infernoids aren't even out yet, you know. We address them when they come out, if they need new dressing. But from what I'm seeing in Infernoids, I'm not impressed. So, I'm not even sure if that deck's going to be even relevant in comparison to the strength of the current decks. You know, for something that's inside of Cleeput, they just don't seem as strong as Cleeput. So, I don't know. Alright. Next, Skill Drain should be hit since Cleeput recently got into OCG, I think it means TCG, you know. As I said, I definitely hope this Skill Drain gets hit. It will definitely be on my list, but if it doesn't get hit, I wouldn't be surprised. But, yeah. Alright, next. Crazy to think this, but since Regeki, I have been hoping Harvey's Feathers comes out. No, it's not. Stop. Harpy's Feathers is not gonna come off. There's a difference. There's a huge difference with Regeki and Harpy's Feather Dust. A huge fucking difference, alright? How can you think that Harpy's Feather Dust is gonna come off when Heavy Storm is banned? Like, no. Very friend upon for that whole mass background destruction. You can generally tell that Konami TCG likes the acro a little bit more than the average, card game slash player. You know, they're kind of fan for the back row. You know, there's a party for, you know, hate back row and love back row. Konami would be more in the love back row section. So, they're not gonna unban Heavy Storm. You know, they're trying to be a little bit less biased. They're not gonna be like, hey, Heavy Storm banned, MST at 1, Propulse to 3, Bombless to 3. You know, they're not gonna be that crazy. They tried to balance it out with the banning of Heavy Storm. They tried to balance out the back row. They did a fairly decent job. You know, with Mirror Force and Deep Attack 3, I mean, you know, battle cards aren't even that powerful anymore. No, they're not going to bring back copies by the Duster. Alright, and since Pendulums came back in, cards that destroy face of fellow trap cards, like Intense Bug Dragons, will get limited or banned. I was kind of wondering about that. I kind of thought that maybe Intense Spellfire Ghost is actually going to do something, but it didn't. It absolutely didn't do anything. So I don't even think anybody even cited it. But, so that's not even a thing. No, I think it's going to skip by in the ban list. Like I said, if it starts popping up next list and, you know, Kleepers start getting fucking straight up wrecked and not even topping or doing anything because of this card, then, you know, I can definitely, see that occurring, you know. I can definitely see that just being a thing of Enter Spell Dragons getting hit because it's hitting their money deck. You know, Kleepers are the money child right now. That's the main deck that they want to make money off of. So, I see that maybe later, but first it has to be played first. You know, I don't see this any of this preemptive hit shit. Alright, so, we have StuDog8 here. He has one thing to say, so I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and, read it. So he says, Turgon needs to be hit. I agree. And wouldn't be surprised if Pot of Greed comes back one of these days. One of these days, I guess. Konami did say that they want to try and unban every card and see whether it's broken or not. But, am I for Pot of Greed? I'm definitely not. I'm not on the side of Pot of Greed. I know what everybody's saying, like, oh, Pot of Greed is so good and everybody can play it. It's a balanced card. No, it's not. Alright, in a game of luck, where you can draw and your opponent can't draw, Pot of Greed would just be an unhealthy card because it's a no-cost plus one. That sure anybody can play, but you gotta keep in mind, since this game is luck based and it's also randomized, you're not sure if you're gonna get it. So, of course, it's not fair to have Pot of Greed when you have Pot of Greed and your opponent doesn't have Pot of Greed, your opponent's up. What your opponent draws with Pot of Greed, what you don't draw with Pot of Greed, that's also different. So, it's not really fair to say that. And of course, with Magician of Faith at 3, I really can't say in good conscience that Pot of Greed should come back with Magician of Faith at 3. Like, Pot of Greed comes back, Magician of Faith at 3, you're just screaming, hey, Exodia decks, go to town. Because that's gonna be fucking ridiculous. Like, no. Pot of Greed is just naturally unhealthy for the game. It's better for the game, and more balanced for the game that no one has Pot of Greed instead of everybody having Pot of Greed. Because at that point, it wouldn't be fair. Because, you know, unless it led me to a perfect world where everybody starts off with Pot of Greed, it's just naturally just not unfair. And I agree, Turgon needs to be hit. Alright, so here's part two. We still got a couple more parts to go, so we're definitely going to be getting to them. Like I said, I apologize to the tag partners, but I definitely need to get this done. This needs to be done yesterday, so. But I don't want to sit here and do an hour-long video, because like I said, with this and yesterday's part, that's already 40 minutes, and I'm still not even close to done. So, of course, we're gonna continue down people's comments and list, and still talking about this. And of course, on the first, I will have my my balance prediction up. So, I hope that you guys enjoyed this part two. Be sure to come back for part three. So, thanks for watching. Thanks for all the support, and I will see you guys tomorrow with part three. All right, thanks for watching.